death is coming. During the year of the Cobra, a prisoner captured by unknown means was transported into the exiled lands, crucified, and left to die for crimes that they may or may not have committed. Death comes swiftly on black wings, until fate intervenes.
Thirsty, dead man. Shall I cut you down from that corpse tree? It might kill you. You civilized men are soft. Your lives are not nailed to your spines. Where I come from, we kill our enemies in battle. We don't leave them in the desert to die like dogs. So, you live again, dead man. This land does not love men. You are marked. Cross the ghost fence wearing that. It might have been kinder to leave you on the cross. Live. Love. Burn with life. Slay and survive. We will meet again, dead man.
of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways lie the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city.
I am beaten, left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here, slaves, bandits and cannibals, exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on. The life that I left behind haunts me. The sun over the glittering spires of Belverus has forever denied me. The smell of my daughter's hair. I will pass the ghost fence, and this cursed land will finally end me. To whoever reads this note, I leave the last of my water and this message. Stranger, you have my pity. You do not know how cursed you truly are.
Curse this sandstorm. We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingled with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
Thank you. Thank you.
Another new one, eh? I can smell it on you. Veterans tend to smell just a little more like despair. I'm Arcos. Once a sailor, now a wanderer. You didn't think you were the only one, did you? You should go up north. There's whole cities of exiles up there. In the beginning, there were only a few of us. But now, it seems like fresh-faced fools are showing up every week. Not all of them are as friendly as I am, mind you. Watch your step. A lot of desperate people out there. Bracelets? You can't remove them. Saw one fool cut his arm clean off trying to get rid of it. He bled to death right there in the sand. Nasty business. Leave it on. You'll start to hear the voices soon enough, and you'll start seeing the ghosts. I don't think the voices are for us. Not for us here and now. I think they were talking to somebody else. Back then. Wherever it was. Whenever it was. Those pillars keep us confined here. Some call it the curse wall, or the ghost fence, or just the boundary. Doesn't really matter what it's called, does it? I walked all the way around it once. Had to be careful not to cross it, of course. Once in the north, I saw a few people on the other side, wearing bracelets just like ours, with gems of amber. Makes you wonder. Farewell. I won't pin my hopes on seeing you again. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
you.
You picked the wrong fight.
Taste death.
Thank you.
Curse you! Someone's coming.
Thank you. Oop.